soul, clenching my fists in the effort to end all of it. Cause I'm strongly pissed and surely I wouldn't dismiss my talents in my hands despite the fact I'm at my lowest. And as a poet, I wrote this in the effort to know it. Life is worth living when I'm so depressed and obsessed with things that'll cause my death. But then I hear a whisper in my ear. The voice was convicted and very clear. He said, my son surrendered the greatest fears. And it was here that I was brought to tears. Cause he chose me for greater things. Yeah, God sold me. He called me out of darkness and declared me holy. Yeah, then he boldly spoke, saying that he wants to show me how much he knows me. And that's what he told me.
Approximately at 12:42 a.m., your last breath made its way out of the cavity of your lungs and traveled to where I was. The whispers of loneliness crept its way inside my mind and eventually parallel parked onto my heart. Kidnapped by my thoughts, exclaiming the reality that I am now the man of the household. I tried to escape, but these hands were strapped down by my pride and my mouth sewn shut because silence was the way that I used to get by. January 22nd, 2012, I could have been left in a body bag. That bullet could have pierced my spinal cord and I could have been dead, but instead, God's grace spared me one last time. So you see, the reason why I write these lines is so that you can understand the urgency of time. Because at that time, I had just turned 18, I was playing for the basketball team and dibbing and dabbing in a party scene, and quite honestly, it was lovely. You see, I thought I was living the dream until I was twerking at that sweet 16 and 13 people got shot, including me. Although I didn't feel that bullet pierce my skin, reality branded itself into my conscience like a letterman. You see, we live every day as if we are promised tomorrow, treating every day as if we will be granted the next, until we get that sudden text that cousin David died. How about before getting that text, we pay our respects now by respecting the one who paid the highest price for your life. Your life is not your home. It's time we stop paying so much attention to our cell phones, our eyelashes, and our nails, and realize that he paid for you with lashes, and he paid for you with nails. Your life is not your
night. still have trouble for you.